Do you accept that those kinds of therapies can cause these people harm? In some cases, some people may suicide because they feel rejected for their sexual orientation.
Look, there are people who have felt rejected for a whole range of reasons, and that has caused them hardship and harm. I absolutely accept that. I think that there's many people of different sexual orientations in the church. There's always a distinction between what someone feels and how someone chooses to live. And so there may be people who feel in themselves that they are gay, and there are people like that in the church, but they choose to live differently. Look, I accept that people have been harmed by conversion therapy practices in the past.
But if you have a look online, I mean, it's quite plain to see that there are communities, congregations in Australia that are offering 12-week courses for people who are experiencing same-sex attraction. Is that not the same thing?
Well, I guess it comes down again to what you mean by conversion therapy. I accept that there is opportunities for people who want to talk about these issues to get together with other individuals and talk about them. I wouldn't call that gay conversion therapy. I'd call that counselling that people voluntarily sign up to, and if they want to do that, then more power to them.
But what are they being counselled on? Is it because something's wrong with them?
Well, they're being counselled on their sexual issues and that kind of thing. Look, I think that somebody who is a Christian, who is on that journey, will have those sorts of realisations about their desires. And they'll say, well, okay, the best thing for me is to not act on that impulse and not act on that desire. And again, I mean, this is not unusual in Christian circles. This is people want this for themselves. And if that's conversion therapy, I just find that really hard to swallow.
Is it a sin to be gay?
It's not a sin to be gay, but there is moral rights and wrongs around the Christian faith which say that certain conduct is wrong.
Does it say that it's a sin to act on homosexual feelings?
It says that it's a sin, yes. It says that it's a sin to act on any sexual desire outside of marriage, which is a union of one man, one woman, to the exclusion of all others for life. If a person does not uphold the sexual conduct standards of a church, then they don't have to be a part of it. It's totally up to them.
If it's not a sin to be gay, but it's a sin to act on gay feelings, is that not a contradiction?
No, and it's just a worldview question, you know. You know, there are some people who just believe that desire is one thing, action is another. I mean, look, someone's sexual orientation must be able to change because I have spoken to a huge number of people who report exactly that happening, and I see the evidence of it in their life.
Hello, I'm Sarah Abo. Thanks for watching. To keep up with the latest from 60 Minutes Australia, make sure you subscribe to our channel. You can also download the 9Now app for full episodes and other exclusive 60 Minutes content.